Okay, so we have Juvederm Vollure here today, which is FDA approved for the nasolabial folds. And a lot of people ask, why is it the nasolabial folds that are approved? Well, remember back in the days of collagen before 2003, that's where everything was FDA approved upon. Restylane came in 2003 and was FDA approved nasolabial fold. So it's an easy way to get products approved, but also it's an area that isn't filled that much. Embracing this area often looks good, especially if the patient looks down. With our patient lying back, you don't see much of a fold, of course, but when she sits up or sits forward, she'll see just a slight amount of collagen loss. So cleaning, I'm going to clean here, and the most important thing we're doing is cleaning and preparing the area. Okay, now the first thing I'm going to do, her fold starts down here, and this is the triangle that we're going to fill. If you want to feel, bite down for me for a minute, the front of the facial artery comes up here in front of the masseter, comes up, you get your inferior labial, superior labial, and then your nasalis and your angular. So you want, we are in that layer, you have to watch, you're watching for any blanching, you're looking as you fill. You're gonna get a little poke here, I'm gonna start lower in the fold, a little tiny poke. Now this has lidocaine in it, it's Juvederm Vollure XC. XC stands for extra comfort, and patients appreciate that. Pressure is really important. Not enough injectors, I find, take their time and put pressure. Getting through the injection, it's important to make the injection process so that it doesn't take a long time. However, putting a little bit of pressure and filling, at the same time, I'm going antegrade and retrograde, constantly moving. So if we were in a vessel, we're moving through it. So a little bit of pressure here, and I take my time. And the next thing I'm going to fill is the triangle or the nasal ala up here. Now, you can also inject on the periosteal level. Remember, it's a safer level because there's not a lot of vessels, but you want to reflux. Here I'm going to be just below in the fat layer because she doesn't have a deep fold, injecting antegrade. But if it was a deep fold, I might put a deposit down on the periosteal level and just moving. You're going to need a little more product up through here, but not much. And there you go. That's enough to brace the nasolabial fold, complete the beautiful look. She has a beautiful high cheekbone here, a nice upturn of the mouth, gorgeous lips, no downturn here. So this really creates a nice angle to her face. Look sideways for me. I always like to look at the angle of the face. I like to look at the nose to the chin and this A or E line and make sure this cheek is nice and high and beautiful. If that wasn't the case, I could add a little product through here and that would further pick this fold up. So now we're on the patient's left. We've already filled here and you can see there's less of a hollow. It has a more anterior projection of that nasal ala. And on this side, which is untreated, we're gonna cleanse. You can just see things are deeper, and probably this side is a little bit deeper than the other side. But again, we have a very nice, beautiful cheekbone, a nice, beautiful high cheek, and you're gonna get a little poke here. This time we're gonna start up higher and I'm gonna inject the nasal ala here. And I'm injecting antegrade, watching the skin. And she needs a little more product on this side than the other side. Now symmetry, nobody is fully symmetric from side to side, but every time we inject our patients, we try and achieve symmetry. And cleanse, and we're gonna come down. I'm gonna inject down here, a little tiny poke here. So you're almost always gonna use more product on one side than another. And that's why our pictures are so important, so we can follow her over the years and see how it's holding up. This product is FDA approved. We're gonna cleanse a little bit, no more needles. FDA approved for 18 months. So it doesn't mean in 18 months it's going to be gone. What it means is that 60% of the patients had a result at 18 months when 1.7 on average was used, 1.7 vials were used on each side in the study. She may well not want more product here for 3 or 4 or 5 years. Her cheek is beautiful, she's got great skin, she does regular maintenance for her skin at home, and just the stretch of this product into these folds is gonna create long-term collagen. Okay, how is our patient? How are you doing?
Okay.
How is the pain? Scale of 1 to 10, 10 bad?
I mean one.
You do amazing at breathing and relaxing, it's amazing, but so not too painful from other things you've had done.
No.
So it's a great product, it's comfortable, fairly quick to inject, and remember, it's the overall aesthetic appearance that we're worried about with the patient and the concern creating beautiful angles, proportions, and prevention. Thanks for joining me today. Let us know your comments below in this YouTube channel, and stay tuned here for continued helpful tips. Keep your skin and body beautiful, healthy, and vibrant.